We will take as the next speaker the China Union of Anthropological and Ethnological Sciences.
I'm here.
Good afternoon. I'm from the Research Institute of Humanity. I have just heard the intervention by South Mongolia Information Center. I believe their intervention is not based on facts. I'm someone born a Mongolian in Inner Mongolia in China. My growth is the embodiment of the development in China. When I took the examination for the university entrance examination, I was given a preferential treatment by adding 10 points to it. And I have also been given the opportunity to do a master's course. Although I live in Beijing now, I still visit the Inner Mongolia 3 or 4 times a year, and the life living standard of my family and relatives have been bettered a lot. The children can have the opportunity to learn their traditional culture, and they also conduct traditional wedding ceremonies in Inner Mongolia. So what I have witnessed is totally different from what was said in the intervention. I live in Beijing. I'm also involved in the effort to protect the rights of the minorities. Our work is to support the minority young people to involve in the development in the cities. The urbanization and development in China is moving rapidly forward. Many young people from the rural areas are looking and seeking for better lives in the city. In order to help them to integrate into the city urban life better, our focus is on the communities, to allow the young people of the ethnic minorities to have the opportunity. They have very strong ability to accept the new way of life, and they can become the bridge between today's China and their minority ethnic groups. And we also do our best to help them, to provide public service to them, to help them develop their culture and language and so on and so forth. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Again, a good example of timekeeping. Thank you. And thank you very much for sticking close to the topic of participation of minority youth in public life.